Well, that was an utterly friendly welcome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good to level things out right out the gates. You know, just mess up at the front end and then it's just uphill from there. It could be just playing after Jeremy Dutcher is nearly impossible. Give it up for Jeremy.
Watching the fire.
grass would grow in a rickety house by the shore.
The truth. Thank you.
you want to know. Silence from that court. Sometimes there's a song I'm about to start to play that I haven't played in a long time, and I'm thinking, what record was this on? When did I write this? And all I just remembered about this one was that myself and someone across an ocean were in love, and we were in different time zones for many swaths of months at a time, such that we would do these things called moon dates, where we'd know at least the moon would be in the sky if it was midnight or if it was noon. You could find it. And so we'd pick a time, and then we would just meet our eyes at the same celestial body and think, and that way we're sort of together for a split second. I know that his eyes are there, he knows my eyes are there. And so in that way, I started to think about dawn for me, dusk for him, this sort of idea of the world is turning and we're on the wrong sides of it. And so that's what this is about. Then you yearn and yearn and yearn and yearn, and then the pandemic hits. And then you're in the same house with the same people for long lengths of time. Wait, hold on one second. And of course that was a beautiful, strange. It could be, it could have been, I'm sure for many things were true at once in that time when we were with the same people. But one thing I know is that a repetition does teach you something. There's a chance to learn again every day what you did wrong, what you might have done better, or what that person said, what hurt, how much of you to hide, how much of you to show, because there was nowhere to hide, really. Maybe people, what they mean, offices in their closets and stuff. I ended up in a shed where I wrote a lot of songs, this one included. So this is my forever, my ode to the pandemic, and to the people I was lucky enough to learn a lot about myself with. Because it turns out, everybody's got their shit, but who's got the guts to sit with it? Everybody's on their own, and that we're never alone. But the deeper in a thousand times, that'll get you every time. There are a thousand different ways to hide.
A thousand ways to be fair.
a union house, so I have to give them at least 10 minutes off every 25 minutes. I guess it's just certain songs that I really found because of solitude in a strange way. They really need to be played alone. This one in particular, the last song in this one are from a record I put out just not so long ago called Multitudes. Yeah. And that shed I mentioned, that shed with the single window and the sort of musty smell. And that blessed solitude that was in there with me. That was written. I spent time in that shed when I thought, I really truly believe this may never happen again. And I was left with this kind of wealth of a language that I'd established with myself and my feelings over the years, where it felt like when things made the least sense, the best you could do is write obtuse lyrics about it and try to make sense of it yourself. And so I just ended up writing love songs to the place where I was, the people I was with, to my brand new baby, little tiny person who was learning the world was this very quiet place with trees and very few people around. And it was such a strange, and it's a time out of time that I'm glad I have these little artifacts with me to remember that time.
Thank you.
So, Jeremy Dutcher, we need to come back to that subject. Jeremy Dutcher. Jeremy Dutcher sings as if the truth and like he just knows it so intimately. There's a resonance in the expression and what he's expressing and how he's relating to the present and the past and building a future from that place that from the first time I watched him sing, I felt like I was learning something about the thing I'd done my whole life. And I was learning how to do it from an entirely different place inside of me. Sometimes there can be. There's a certain sort of otherness. It's not the same person who's buying yogurt or who's fighting with whoever they need to fight with at that time. I'm just saying. But I feel that the same person who wakes up in the morning, who does anything through the day, that then comes on stage and just channels the truth is. That's what I've learned from watching Jeremy. And there's, I wrote this next song kind of because over the years I've seen in myself and all of my friends who also play that there's often a bit of a mask. There's just something that is not entirely resonant with the person that maybe they wake up knowing themselves to be. A different thing happens on stage. You kind of come up here and there's like a slightly other thing. And it's called A Man Is Not His Song, and I would say that's not always the case. Sometimes a man is his song. A man is not his song. A song is a promise. If a man is just a song, can some be beyond us? Well, how they make it up? Till it sends into creation. But eventually, it can let you down. By believing and still in operation.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
And there's a beautiful mahogany dance floor right here. If anyone wants to breach all of protocol and come and dance right here, it would make me very happy. Anyone on an important date or something? Now I throw the gauntlet down for you.
Okay. So cute.
we can do our comedy bit.
I'm ready if you are.
I think it was, I'm going to say maybe last year or 2 years ago, that I saw Jeremy had covered a song of mine that I hadn't played in many, many years called Graveyard. And was it 2 years ago?
Yeah.
2 years ago. It was a beautiful choral arrangement, and I listened to the song almost as if I hadn't written it. It just felt like it had been lifted into entirely new territory, and you, in a way, gave it back to me. And I haven't had a chance or the will or the way to sing it until we get to do it together.
Water is life, you know? That's the highest compliment you can pay somebody who's taken on a song of someone else. It's a fear, you know? Stepping into that, it's such a beautiful song, and I'm so happy to share it with you right now. This is a dream come true.
The graveyard offered my love, the only age the beating heart's empty around, in dirt and grass, the shadow home, the moon. Did anyone drive here from
Toronto? Yes!
Okay, so you guys do this part. Americans, join the Torontonians, as you know you want to do. Okay, everyone together. Thank you. here with you. Have a beautiful weekend.